Are you ready to do an experiment?
What is it?
Well, have you ever stacked a tower of building blocks to see how tall you can make it?
Of course.
Well, today we're going to be making a tower out of liquids.
But how are we going to stack liquids on top of each other?
Well, let's get our thinking caps on.
Oh, yeah.
And begin building our tower.
What will we need?
A tall glass or mason jar, a few different liquids, honey, corn syrup, dish soap, water and food colouring, oil, and rubbing alcohol. If you don't have them, use what you have. The more the better though. A turkey baster or a small syringe and a cup. If you have a measuring cup, measure out half a cup of honey. If you do not have a measuring cup, you can make a mark on the cup with a marker and pour each liquid to the same mark every time. It is very important that you use the same amount of each liquid. Carefully and slowly pour out the honey into the tall glass, being very careful to make sure that the honey does not touch the side of the container. Leave the honey to settle for a few seconds. Make sure you wash out the measuring container after you have measured each liquid. Next, you're going to measure out half a cup of corn syrup. Carefully pour the corn syrup into the container, making sure it does not touch the side of the container. Next, measure out half a cup of dish soap and pour it into the container. Once the dish soap has settled, you will need to measure out half a cup of water. Then add food colouring to the water so that you'll be able to see it in the tower. Get the turkey baster and squeeze up the water. Then place the baster against the side of the container and carefully squeeze it out so that the water drains down the side of the container. Repeat the process using oil. Remember to make the oil trickle down the side of the container. Finally, you will repeat the process with the rubbing alcohol. This may not stay in the baster very well, so you might have to put your finger over the hole to stop it trickling out. Now you have made a liquid tower. It's fun to look through the layers with a flashlight. Here we see the honey, corn syrup, dish soap, water, oil, and rubbing alcohol.
Whoa, that's cool! But how is it possible?
Because each liquid has a different density.
Density? What is that?
Well, every liquid is made up of molecules. The density is the measure of how close those molecules are together. The more dense a liquid is, the closer the molecules are together.
So all of these liquids have different densities?
You got it! Which one do you think is the most dense? That's right, the honey. The molecules in the honey are packed together very closely, so it is very dense. This means that it is the most dense liquid in the container, which is why it is at the bottom. As we go up through the container, the liquids get less dense, which means that they float on the liquids below them.
So that must mean that the rubbing alcohol is the liquid that is the least dense.
Absolutely. So now we have a challenge for you.
What happens if?
You could drop small objects of different weights into the container. Try dropping a nail or a ping pong ball or something else small. They will have different densities, so they will float at different levels. What other objects could you investigate? A quarter, a chocolate chip, an eraser? An extra bonus for you. What would happen if you used different liquids? Milk, lemon juice, olive oil, maple syrup, soy sauce. The possibilities are endless. Where does the new liquid settle within your liquid tower? Post your answers in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe.
Until next time, my friends, explore more!